Hey guys, welcome back to NK's Mystery Box, and today we are going to do a Sims 4 challenge. So, over my last 2 days off of work, I went ahead and built a complete replica of the house from Beetlejuice. Don't ask me why I decided to do that, and why now, you know, in Valentine's Day. Like, I feel like this is something I should have done for Halloween. But either way, I did it just out of random, just was like, I'm gonna just build a house and see how it turns out. Well, voila! It's here! And I'm taking great pride in this because I'm not that good at actually building decent looking structures in The Sims. I mean, have you seen what I've built? Look at Princess's castle. It looks exactly like the castle, but things are off. Things are wrong. So I'm actually proud for this house, and I take great respect in it. And I saved it in my library so that way I can use it again in the future and not have to completely rebuild it again. And so I figured, all right, as a kid, Beetlejuice was always my, you know, clearly that movie was one of my favorite movies growing up as a kid. Duh. So I always wanted to move into that house that was like that type of size and just kind of layout and stuff like that. I was like, I want a house like that. So I figured I'm going to just move my Sim self into this house and see what happens. And to make it more funny, I thought, why not do a Sims challenge? We haven't done a Sims challenge completely yet. We haven't done the Sim challenge in a while. I tried to do Rags to Riches, and I just completely forgot about it. And then I think I tried to do a challenge of my own, and I just completely forgot it. So I figured, let's pick a challenge that's easy, that I will definitely not forget, no matter how hard I try. And that is the Stepping on the Green Screen challenge. I win. Anyway, so that is the Leaving the Game Unpaused for a length of time. The reason why I say that is normally the challenge is played in the increment of 24 hours. You start your game, you make sure your Sims are set, their needs are all fixed up, and they're good to go, the house is clean, everyone's in the house where they need to be, and then you hit play and walk away. That is the whole point. You leave your game unpaused for 24 hours, and then at the 24-hour mark, you come back to the game, you hit pause, and you review the notifications and see what type of damage happened while you were gone. Because The Sims 4 and all the other Sims games prior, things happen when you walk away from it. You could get up to go to the bathroom and your couch could have been repoed. Your Sim could have died. Your Sim could end up smelly. Appliance broke. All types of stuff could happen. So the idea of leaving it unpaused for 24 hours frightens me to the core. Because it's like, I worked hard on this house. And now I'm offering it to the most ruthless Sims 4 thing that could happen. Like, literally, I'm just saying, okay, whatever happens next is not my fault. And just going from there. So, being that it was set for 24 hours, I really wasn't... 24 hours is a long time, and let's be honest, things can happen. Like, your computer just goes to sleep and the game gets shut off. Or you'd forget, and then before you know it, it's now the 48-hour challenge, and it's like, yeah, there's just other things. So I decided to just do it the stripped-down version, which is just leaving it on overnight. And so last night, around probably 1:17-ish is when things started, and I forgot to do a tour of the house before I did all this stuff. But point being is, I made sure the needs were set for my Sim self, Andrew Sim self, Princess, and I'm not really too worried about the many, many ghosts that are inside the house because they're already dead. But point being is everyone was pretty much fine. And then for the ghosts of the house, except for the cats, I made them hate every living member that was in the household. I made sure everything was fine, everything was great, and then I walked away. Checked up on the game around 7:30, and then at 8:17, I figured that is my overnight, you know, that's a typical overnight for me is, you know, that it's morning now. And I hit pause on the game when it was morning in the game. So now the sun arriveth on the final day of the challenge, and we're going to go in and see what kind of stuff we're going to find. Come on. It's morning, final day. The house on the outside looks okay. And I'm surprised we're back in summer again. Literally, we, like, just to be give an idea of, like, how much time has passed in The Sims, like, it was summer when I started at 1 o'clock this morning, and it's now almost 8:26, and I paused this at, like, 7... We'll just say 8:17 was when I paused it. And the sun has come up, and it's summer again. But, like, throughout the entire night, we went through all seasons. Like, just... Boom! 4 seasons have passed, and we're back again. So, final day. House looks fine on the outside. I don't see anything different. Start moving here. I don't see anything different. The tombstone was already there when we started. That was from one of the ghosts that I had made prior to this. So I'm just gonna go down and just check the yard. We're going to go around the house and check the yard, and then I'll lift up and we'll look at the porch, and then we'll just go in. The fence I did not put. I think that was auto-generated. All right. Oh, I forgot to do brick for that part of the house. I will have to check that. Alright, so we're at the garage entrance. I call it the garage. I know you don't have cars in The Sims 4, but that's what I think this is from my guess from the movie and stuff like that. So we're going to go inside. Initially, this was going to be like the skill room and stuff like that. So I put like a cupcake factory thing in there, a robotics factory, some stuff from the seasons, like the flower thing and the pumpkin carving thing. And then I also put down, I think I put down like a backdrop thing with a picture, so you could take a picture of your sim if you wanted to. So let's go in and see what's in here. See if anything was used. Oh. What's that? Is that hair? Oh. Either one of the ghost cats are shedding, or somehow Princess got down here and decided to shed. Okay. That's just, my brain's like, that's just the topping of the cake, honey. All right, so let's go up. We're up on the porch now. Whoops, wrong way. Alrighty, let's look. Oh my god. Oh no, don't ruin. I bumped the wall and I could just... my corner of my eye saw parts of the inside and I'm like, no, no, no. Oh my god. There's hair everywhere. But I don't understand. I'm pretty sure I know it for a fact. I locked the door so that way Princess couldn't get out and run away. Because I didn't want that happening. Because, you know, she's important. And she's somewhere. I think she's in her cat castle right now sleeping. But point being is her sim self had no option to leave. So I'm assuming these came from the ghost cats? I'm assuming? Either way, wow. Oh my god. We have a ghost. I don't know. I think that's one of the... Obviously it's one of the ghosts. But I'm hoping it's the same one that I started off with. And not Princess. Oh, God, you look kind of like Princess. But you're not. You're Spotted. I think that's Bomber. I think that's the name I named the other cat, was Bomber, because he kept shitting everywhere. Ew. Ew. Oh. Oh. What is that? I feel like I'm an episode of Hoarders. What is that? Hello. Oh, almost went through the wall. That would have been a ruin, wouldn't it? That would have been a spoiler. What is that? Oh, what is that? Oh, it's, ew. Okay, I paused it again, because now we're moving. Every time, if we want to examine something, I'll unpause it, but until, yeah. Wow, ew. Okay. Alright, that was just the outside, now we're going in. Make ourselves a little bit higher because we're not no longer at a child's height. We can be adults here.
adults going in. I think I made myself a little too tall, though. All right. Here we go. I see more cat hair already. This is making me so nervous. I even closed my eyes. All right. So far, all I'm seeing is just a lot of cat hair. Lots of cat hair. That's all that I'm seeing. Okay. I see dirty plates. Oh. Oh, well, I mean, that's not terrible. But I mean, the food's definitely molded. Definitely molded. Oh, yeah. All right, let's go down and just check the... Oh, my God. Oh, my God! Wait. Just somebody really wanted to make bread, and they just decided, eh, I'm done. And then started over with a whole new batch. And somebody doesn't know how to use a sink. Which makes me think that maybe the sink is broken. Oh, that's burned. Oh, no. And this is sad. I can't see in. The windows are too weird. But something burned. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm scared. I'm just gonna close my eyes. Oh, no. Oh, no. What? Oh, my God. And there's a cat roaming around. Oh, no. Okay, unpause it back up. Oh, no. Oh, no, no, no. No. I hope you're the other cat that wasn't princess. I'm really... I made three cats? Yeah, I made three cats that were ghosts on top of princess. So it's like... I know they all look the same kind of as ghosts. So it's like, oh no. Oh no. No, no, no. Alright. I'm gonna hit play and just push through. Okay, so there was a fire in the kitchen, but it didn't get here. Alright. This isn't bad. I was expecting this place... Okay, so there's... The bread monster got in here, too. But, I mean, I was expecting this to be just all burned. I really was. I assumed I was going to have fires. I did, but I didn't know where exactly in the house they would end up being. I did assume the kitchen would burn a little bit, but not like that. And then not get just covered with complete trash. The kitchen is a fucking scene out of Hoarders. It really is. Oh my God. Okay, point that up. Ooh, I really forgot to do the wall there, didn't I? That's why I do videos like these, because then I can see the details and then fix them before I do other things in them. Just totally destroy a house to notice its imperfections. Alright, going up to the second floor. La-ba-da-ba-da. Okay. I already see cat hair. This is making me sad. There's a lot of cat hair. On to the bedroom. Oh my God. Okay, the ghosts are in here. Three ghosts in here. They're both passed out. You got the ragged hag and the other one on the floor and the cat on the bed. And a shit ton of gnomes just came out of nowhere. All these dirty clothes. There's a washer and dryer in the attic room. Pretty sure. Yeah, I put that in there. So, I'm assuming it burned? Or it didn't burn? That's my guess. Now, this room, the study, I made that, and I put a fireplace in here. I'm telling you, I'm expecting huge fire damage. Exactly what I'm expecting. Oh. Somebody died. Don't know who. Somebody died. Don't know who. Oh my god, who is it? We'll find out when we read the notifications. Okay, they had a beer, they had a bowl, they had food, and then they just died. They lived in this room and died. Okay, somebody died. I'm worried. I feel like I'm coming home and this is like, what is this? Okay, attic floor. Final floor of the house. Well, let's check the bathroom first. I forgot there's a bathroom in here. Okay, is anything broken? No. It's possessed by someone. Ooh. Somebody's in the tub. Don't know who. There's a shit ton of dirty plates in here. Someone tried to do food. Ooh. But the sink is working just fine. But the toilet's all clogged. Yep. Okay. That wasn't really too frightening. I was expecting more out of that, to be totally honest. Yep. Alright. The attic. Doop-a-doop-a-doo. Alright, whoa, the camera moves way faster up here. Okay. One, two, three. Yes, so the dryer... Oh, no! Okay, so Andrew and I were the only living ones in the house, so we're both dead, I'm assuming. That confirms it, because there's two urns, so there's no mystery. Me and Andrew both ended up dying. Shit, does that mean Princess died too? Did we all just die in the Beetlejuice house, really? Did we just die? Oh, there was a fire, and whoever got left up here was trapped. Oh, no. Oh, that makes me sad. Alright, well, that was it. Alright. So let's get out of tab mode and read some notifications and see what all happened and kind of piece the story together here a little bit. Oh dear. So the pets, the ghost pets are in need of dire attention. I'm just going to hit play because it really doesn't matter at this point. The ghosts are uncomfortable. It's lottery day. Holy fucking shit. Alright, let's get the Sims back into happiness. All dead of them. All their needs. Still needs of household. There we go. Okay. I'm scared to go back and read everything. Princess must have died. Or she ran away. One of the two. But she's not here. She's just gone. She's just fucking ghost. Alright. Alright. Okay. Blah, blah. I got a video game skill. Lazy lesson. Took a couple more screenshots. Pet obsessions. So far, it's all good stuff. Nothing really... Just this skill, this skill, this skill. Like, everybody's getting skills. Basic start of the... game type stuff, like when your sim first moves in and they haven't really done anything. Apparently the ghost cats start chewing up the furniture. Then there was a fire. At some point there was a fire. A fire started nearby. Maybe your sim should put it out before it spreads out of control. Andrew was the one who discovered the fire, so therefore he was the one who caused it. And then Andrew died in the fire. So let's find Andrew and try to piece it together here. So there was a urn upstairs by the dryer. Yep, that's Andrew. Okay, so Andrew went to go do laundry. It started on fire. And he got trapped up in the attic and died. Okay. In the Sims household has received blah, but we didn't do anything with it. There was another fire. I'm assuming the one down in the kitchen. Random hag started it, so she was trying to chase us out. cats are going hungry. Princess just up and ran away. Oh, so she ran off. She just ran off and never came back. Fuck. She's like, fuck it. Dad's gone. I can't do this. And then she ghosted me for the rest of the challenge. God damn it. Andrew and Princess just clocked out early in this challenge and left me to handle the rest of it. All right. Princess must have come back because it's saying here that she has a peaceful or playful lesson. So she must have come back. I came good friends with Princess. Okay. Princess ran away again. And cats got very hungry, but they were the ghost cats, so it doesn't matter. Bills have just been delivered. Princess ran away again. Princess ran away. So Princess ran away, came back, and then ran away, and then came back, and then ran away again. Then she came back and ran away. She came back and ran away. It's like every day. She's like, I'm not living here, but I'm checking up on you. She's like, this situation's all you, but I'm just making sure you're still breathing. Energy got turned off, I'm assuming, halfway through this, because we're almost close to the top. Princess left again for the day, came again the next day. I was still breathing. She's like, all right, bye. Princess ran away again. Princess is very hungry. Be sure to feed her before she gets taken away. Did she get taken away? Did she, like, come to save me and then couldn't? Like, she's like, today's the last day. I have to save him. I have to do it. And then the frickin' Sims lady came and took her. Princess ran away. Harvest was awful. Of course, because I'm in this house all by myself. My husband died. And then Princess kept running away. Local water company has shut off the water. Pay your bills. Yeah. Apparently I'm becoming friends with the cat. Princess ran away again, so she must have come back at some point. I wish we would have got a notification saying Princess is back, you know? Like a nice blue one. So the random hag ghost started liking Princess. I'm getting into a fight with the other ghost. I got into a fight with her. She must have been telling me dark secrets, and I was like, no. And then I starved to death. I must have ran out of food. Oh. I died. I starved to death. Oh. And then Princess got taken away shortly after that. Well, that makes me sad and depressed. I honestly thought I'd be coming back to the house and there may have been some damage to it, some not, you know, not crazy damage. But yeah, everyone dead. That was just, this is a horror house. Okay, this is now the horror house of February. Like, everybody just died. Oh, I'm not doing this channel any ever again. No, I don't like it. Mm-mm. Well, I guess, I bumped my cat. I guess the only thing is to say next is give this video a like. If you did, give it a huge thumbs up. Like I just said, give it a like. And then, if you guys like this video enough, I will contemplate doing a full-on 24-hour challenge. This was kind of just a run, just kind of a quick test to see like what all would actually happen. And I'm actually fairly pleased with how this Sims 4 leave your game unpaused for a while test has gone. So next time, if we do this again, I will be going a little bit more bigger and we will be doing bigger things. And we will be doing the unpause challenge for 24 hours. If you guys liked this, though. If you didn't, we'll move on to the next thing. So the next challenge I think I'm going to do is I'm going to bring everybody back to life. And maybe do a random outfit challenge or something like that. Do something with random genetics. That sounds like another fun one that I want to do. Which is just random genetics where we just make somebody. And yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!